So I'm at the airport at SFO San Francisco, and check out these typewriters they have on display. It's pretty epic. Like, they have hundreds on display here, all from different periods of time. So let me take you back to the first ones, way over here. Here's some of the first typewriters. Typewriter. It says this one's from around 1830 to 1870. So, look at these. These are epic. Very, very cool. Interesting to see the keyboard designs. And look at these ones, like, starts with Z. ZPRC. There's like a postcard displaying it. And they got pictures of people using them. Over here they got a few more. This is from 1938. It says Orson Welles used this one.
Why would we do that? We're not going to be using it. No.
It's pretty cool. There's a sample, it looks like. Wow, look at that thing. Let's see who. Tennessee Williams. Beautiful. I can see why people get into these and like buy them. So this one's Hemingway. Okay. Yeah. See how many there are here? There's like typewriters all over. Let's see who this one belonged to. The Beatles. John Lennon. What in the world? The Imperial. Look at that machine. That is a work of art. We got one of the Beatles albums there. Ray Bradbury. A Royal. Look at this one, a Chinese typewriter. It's really curious. Never seen anything like that before. Here's a Japanese one. Japanese typewriters. Look at this one on a cylinder. And we got some more ones here. A torpedo. That's pretty cool. A Machba. Another Royal.
We're just missing Wade Ellis. Wade Ellis, please make way to 854B.
This one looks like an old Mac keyboard.
Doors are closing after this message.
The Hermes Arabic configuration. There we go. See those Arabic letters right there? We have this cool typography there. Nice colors they got going. It says this one's from 1954. The Olivetti Lettera. Look at that green keyboard there. That's sweet. You gotta love this Valentine. Look at the red. It's really cool. Look at these posters too. Like, look at this. These are very nice. A nice style of writing there. Let's go back and check these out. It's from 1960. You can learn how to touch type. This gold one, that is a fancy one for fancy stuff. It's an IBM typewriter. It looks like kind of like something my grandpa had. It says number 23, that's an IBM Selectric from 1964. So, there's an Underwood. This is a Hutchison spool of wire flattener, or fastener. There's a Corona. There's a Remington. There's a cute little dog there, typing away. Look at this guy, it's a nice compact. It's a Bickens Durfer number 5 from Stamford, Connecticut. That's where that Stamford branch was, right? You know? Hey.
I'm not sure which one it is.
It was a Victor type. You gotta love the different keyboard designs. Like, you know, we've kind of standardized, but they really had a lot going for the different ones. Like, what's happening here? This is a Sun typewriter from New York, 1885. Now this thing here is an Odell typewriter number 4 from 1900. So, who knows what was going on there? They had some interesting ideas. I think I've covered most of these, but let's look at them again. Franklin number 7, Franklin Typewriter Company, New York, 1902. Williams Typewriter, New York, 1895. And the Oliver Typewriter, that was from 1913, from Chicago. This one's from New York in 1890. The Grandall. The Crandall, new model, 1890. And number 8 is the Hammond from New York in 1890. Look at that keyboard design, that's kind of something else. Chicago, 1905, I think we've seen these ones. Ooh, look at this typometer, 10 cents. So I don't know what costs 10 cents, but. It says this one was from 1927, from Remington. All right, well that's some cool stuff here. I guess this one's from 1875, the Scholes Glidden typewriter from New York City. Look at that keypad. So, that's the keyboards.